May contain nuts. Hello world and welcome back to my Minecraft Survival Challenge. Today it's raining, and not only in Minecraft, it's raining in the real world as well. Every now and then you might hear a crack of thunder. If so, I do apologise, I'm not responsible for that. Honest. So, what were we doing last time? Last time we went mining, didn't we? How's that coming along? Yeah. We're doing stuff. Right, probably need to do more mining, but I don't want to bore you all too much. We should probably replant some of our forest as well. That wouldn't hurt, would it? Where did we put all the saplings? Because we're gonna need. No, that's wood. There we are. Right, we're gonna need trees. Right, we are gonna need tree. There's definitely gonna be a need for tree. Yeah, definitely need trees. And there's monsters. And run away. Why are there always monsters? And my sword is almost dead. I should probably make a new sword. You can feck off, witch. Bugger off. Go wee. Leave me alone. Let's kill her. Right, what do we need? We're gonna need... Do we have a stick? We have a stick. We're gonna need 2 iron. I don't want to go in my furnace because it's still smelting. That's the wrong one. There we are. Right, 2. 1, 2. Good job I can count all the way to 2, don't you think? Oh my god, there are monsters out there. I should probably put up iron doors as well. Yeah, well, we'll worry about that when we need to. When I've died from mobs or something at some point. Right, farming. Potato lives there. Potato lives here. Mob drops. You can go there and, well, yeah, balls to it. Flint. Collecting a fair bit of flint. We need to start harvesting our chickens for reasons of arrow. Right, I saw a zombie go past. There you are. Wow, did you kill the witch? Where'd the witch go? There is a witch. There was a witch out here a minute ago, and oh, that was a creeper up there, but it's not. Right. Where did the witch go? Where did the witch go? What did you do to her? What did you do to the witch? Zombie, you stupid. There we are. Right, let's go plant these trees. If I get blown up now, I'll be so sad. Om nom 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 nom. Nothing worse than being blown up when you don't want to be blown up. Alright. We definitely need a tree. We're going to need oak. We're going to need lots of oak. That roof. Can't even see it from here. That'll need fixing, and I need to complete my house at some point. Got this huge list of things I'd like to do, and I'm just not doing them. Because I just suck, basically. Sval sucks, that's the new name of the series. Sval, you suck. And that's unfortunate, because, well, if you suck, things suck, and generally suck. How many times can I say the word suck in a single sentence? Well, suck, suckity, suck, 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 suck. Isn't that right? Whee! Oh, I tell you, I feel absolutely bushwhacked at the minute, and if you're not sure what bushwhacked means, I'm knackered. Ooh. Oh. I am exhausted. I've been working way too hard. Is that really that many trees? Go figure. Yeah, working way too hard. Oh, look at that. Oh, nice. That doesn't actually look too bad from here, but the roof definitely needs to be taller. Yeah, we can worry about that. Right, there's something else I wanted to do. Can't remember what it was. Oh well. Yeah, been working way too hard. Bank holiday recently, and I'm absolutely knackered from that. Because I was working, and working on a bank holiday is not easy, I have to tell you. Really, really exhausting work, because everybody wants to visit the zoo. Everybody wants to be where I work. And as much fun as that might seem, well, problems abound. Some steel doors. Not steel doors, wooden doors. Nah, let's not. Let's leave it for now. You finished smeltering. Smeltering? God, I can't even English anymore. You ever known a British person? See, I'm doing it again. Ever known a British person that struggles so much just to English? It's not like it's one of the borrowed tongues of the land or anything like that. I'm loath to call it a native tongue because English is just created from so many other languages. It's just stolen. English is just stolen so much. So much! Why is there no gold? I need more gold. Yeah. I'm also going to need to make a pickaxe at some point. Oh, that roof looks depressing. Okay. We will figure that out. Going to need a lot more wood, though. So trees, I mean, there's plenty of trees there, but I want these ones down here to grow, and waiting for them to do that might take a while. So let's go explore what's downstairs, shall we? See what the mob spawner has spawned. Got some interesting stuff. Right, I'll just dump a crap load of that in there. No room. No room at the end. Ooh, more trees. More. Yeah. See what I mean? English. Wrong way down. Seriously, if the real world was anything like Minecraft, I'd have broken my ankles in the real world by now. I don't actually just go running off a cliff. I'm led to believe that that kind of stuff is bad for your long-term health. I mean, I could be wrong. Has happened before. Not often, admittedly. So admit to being wrong. So serious times for the UK, whilst we're on the topic of being British and Britishness and English and all shit like that. There is a referendum coming up, whether or not we should be part of the EU. You might have heard me mention it at some point. And I probably made my stance quite clear. I think we should remain. Why? Because, well, I'm just not an asshole. No rational argument for leaving, right? As far as I'm concerned, the argument for leaving is based entirely on the principle of an appeal to emotion. You know, it's appealing to some sense of nationalism, which is not rational. And not even a positive kind of nationalism. Because, yeah, it does exist. Nationalism that leads to patriotism that benefits the people of the country. I can't argue with that. But the kind of nationalism built upon the idea of bloody foreigners coming here and stealing our jobs and all our benefits. I don't know, they can do both, and I don't know how that contention can even be made. I don't know, it's just... doesn't appeal to me. It's all the foreigners' fault. Does not appeal to me. Chronic underinvestment in public services? Well, it's because the foreigners are stealing it all. Yeah, I just don't buy it. Do not buy it. There we are. Iron ingots. And, you know, some people do, and, you know, that's fine. That's fine. Need more coal down here. That's absolutely fine as far as I'm concerned. Yeah, you're welcome to believe what you want. But this shit affects me as well as you. So, you know, I would rather people made these decisions based on the head, not on the heart. Right? That's just the way I wish it was. You see, brilliant exercise in democracy. Really, truly is. Trouble is, democracy only works, right, when the people making the decisions are well-informed and voting with their heads. I'm afraid that's just not something the British public are good at. I cherish personal freedom, civil liberties, democracy, the whole lot. But I do think the average voter is a bit less inclined to vote sensibly than they ought to be for the system to work well. Which is unfortunate. So I'm actually, it's quite terrifying, this vote, because my entire way of life could be changed by people who vote because they don't like foreigners. What is that? I mean, really? Come on. They come in here because they want a better way of life, and they contribute, right? I mean, yes, you can take too many too quickly, I accept that. Public services do struggle. But these people are not coming here and not working. These people are coming here and working. They pay taxes, they pay their share, they pay their way, the overwhelming majority of them. I would be surprised if the proportion of foreign people coming here to work is any different to the proportion of British people that already live here working. You know, I'd be very surprised if those numbers vary too much from one another. And, you know, that means that they're paying into the system, which means they're making a contribution, which means their share of public services should be covered. The real reason we're struggling to pay for things, the reason public services are struggling, isn't because foreigners are coming here and using it all. No. It's because we have a government that habitually fails to invest properly. I mean, you can make any argument as to why that's happening, but the simple answer is we have a Tory government, and they hate spending money on public services. You know, just historically, generally, as a rule, on principle. Anything that is handed to anyone else to help them, that they feel you haven't earned, they just detest it. I don't know why. I mean, when the weakest in society, when the most vulnerable in society are well cared for, we all benefit. Because it puts them in a position to contribute more. Yeah, I mean, that's demonstrably true. It is. It's just a fact. But for some reason, there's this entire ideology that, oh, if you haven't earned it, right? Earning, to my mind, is contributing into the system, which everyone does. Everyone pays tax. Everyone pays VAT on every frigging thing they buy. So you're paying into the system. You should be entitled to get something out of it. And some people need to take more out than they put in. That is a simple fact of life. Not everyone can contribute equally. And we should be there to help the people that cannot. There's a difference between someone who will not and someone who cannot. I don't think that MPs contribute anywhere near as much to society as the average worker. They get paid more. And because they pay more in and they earn more, they get all their expenses. But I mean, expenses in the UK for MPs, right? We pay 100 million quid a year in MPs' expenses. That, to my mind, is just ridiculous. That is a stupid amount of money. And I don't think they're worth it. I just don't. Right, I need to increase this idea. I'm on a rant now, and I'm also thinking. Yeah, need the materials. We need a crap ton of wood and a bunch of netherrack. And possibly more quartz. Yeah, I don't think they're worth what we pay them for. I don't. I mean, these people earn figures in the range of, it's like 30 to 60, 70K. And I understand you might need a base of operations. You'll have a home in your constituency, but that might be where they're from. And then they will also need one in Westminster. But when students need a home, they put them in blooming dorms, right? I understand you can't afford to buy every student a house, but why should we buy every MP a house? Why don't we have, like, MP dormitories? It'd be cheaper for us. They'd have somewhere to sleep, and they'd know what it was like to have to work for a living. To not get everything handed to them on a plate. That'd be nice, wouldn't you think? I'm getting into politics now, and that's all dull and boring, and that's not where the Nethercourse is. That's where the Nethercourse is. Okay. And I don't know. I mean, I'm probably being a bit vindictive, but this isn't because they get stuff that I don't have. That kind of thinking, I hate. But it's that these people get these things handed to them. I'm not saying it's easy being an MP. But they don't all turn up and do their job all the time. I understand there's other things they'll have to do. But, if they're going to claim that they're worth, we've got 40K each a year, right? And on top of that, their expenses. I don't know, I think they should have to work a hell of a lot harder than that. Because they expect us to. And they do. They do. They really do. It just grates a bit, that these people who get all this. I mean, they can claim for every meal, every bit of transport they have, and I can't do that where I work, right? If I tried doing that, they'd sack me. I have to pay my own way. From my wages, I have to pay to travel to work, to get food when I'm at work, and to do any other work-related stuff. Now, you might just say, well, I'll just get a better job, but why? Why should there be one rule for one people and another for another? Now, if every MP was always turning up for every vote and every decision, I could understand that. I love democracy, but I just don't like the way it's implemented in this country, is basically what I'm getting at. Seriously, seriously. I don't know. I just think it's ridiculous. Well, get down off my high horse now, but you know what I'm getting at, don't you? You understand. I hope you understand. It's just great in there because it makes them seem so out of touch, and they're not all out of touch. A lot of them do a genuinely good job, and they don't all claim equally on expenses. Like Jeremy Corbyn, the leader of the opposition in the UK at the minute, he claimed, I think something like last year, it was like £3.85, right, for the year. And you get other MPs who claim for having their pond cleaned, right? So you see what we're getting at. I don't believe that politicians are inherently corrupt. I do not believe that that is a thing. I believe that something can become that way. And I think some allow themselves to fall a little bit and take the system for granted. But who doesn't? You get a certain privilege, you take it for granted. But does that mean the privilege should be maintained? No. I don't know. Anyway, yeah, so it sounds like I hate the system and I hate the people who support it. Yeah. I don't know. I don't know. I really don't. I'm gonna stop ranting about politics now because I don't want to bore you, but yeah. These are just things that grind my gears. Yeah, I'm gonna have more floor space up here, aren't I? So this should be cool. Nice. I have to be careful when I mine up there because I don't want to end up tossing things in the fire because I'm gonna need all this. This is all essential stuff. Oh wow, can you hear that noise, aren't I? Someone's using a jackhammer just outside. That is weird. I mean, that's some pretty impressive potholes. Gotta be honest. But I'm not going to get back into politics. And believe me, that is politics. Right. No, do not want. Let's just put some dirt down here. So if I want to get back up, I can. Okay. I'll leave that there. We are going to... there. Okay. That'll work. That'll work. Boop, 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 boop. Boop, boop, boop. Boop, boop, boop. Jump! Nice. I think when you try and make a jump and you just don't make it that far. I mean, that is me just so often. Oh, wrong bloody tool. Get rid of them. They're in the way. I don't need them. Right, you. Oh, I keep pressing 3 instead of 2. Right, we'll put that in slot 2. That should help. Boosh! Did I get it? Did I pick it up? I think I picked it up. Right. Yeah, there we go. Nom. Okay. So. Boosh. That right? I think that's right. Boop. Yeah. Should concentrate on building. But you know. Boop, 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 boop. No, right, that's all wrong. Ah, crap. Oh. Right. Boosh. No, don't go down there. Oh, dropped it. I dropped one, and no, not the smelly kind. There we are. Boop. No. Boop. 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 Right, down we go. Okay. So that creates a sort of roofish structure. Did I drop one? Where'd it go? No. Right. That is going to look... Well, I can always... Yeah, that's not going to be too bad by the time I'm done with it. Boom, 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 boom. Run out of steps. Yes, I can get more from there, but let's go craft a couple more. I mean, we only need a couple more. Not like we need a shit ton of them or anything like that. Ow! Don't think that actually did any damage, but ow, nonetheless. Right, you, give me stairs. Yeah, so, yeah, the basic gist of my life is that I'm passionate about politics. I could go on about it for hours. But, I get a feeling you get bored of it. Especially if you disagree, I mean... God, that's the other trouble in the UK. You cannot have a serious political discussion with people because they just completely dismiss your opinion if it is not one, you know, if it's not agreeing with theirs. And you know, I can kind of understand the point of view because you just don't want to hear what you don't want to hear. I mean, I take that approach myself. I mean, I'm fascinated by other people's political views, most specifically about how they reach their conclusions. Am I dropping them down there? No, must be unintentionally picking them up then. Okay, you. Yeah, I mean, I'm fascinated by other people's political inclinations, especially in hearing about how they reach those ones, because everyone has a reason for why they support a particular stance or party or group. And usually it comes down to something very personal, which is why so many people vote with their hearts rather than with their heads. And that's fine, it's a legitimate way to vote, and my issue is I find that sad that that's a legitimate way to vote. Because I would rather live in a world where people make their decisions based on rational things, because then you're going to get something. I think you're going to get a better system that way. I'll just say that. I think it's going to work better that way. Not everyone will agree with that. Some people think that politics should be all about heart. I mean, if you're, you know, heart is passion, isn't it? And if you're not passionate about something, well, what's the point? But I just think when it comes to some things, The Heart should just be kept out of it. Like, what is best for the UK? Remaining inside the EU or outside the EU? And appeals to nationalism or past glories and shit like that. I mean, that isn't something that should be encouraged. Because we're not living in the past. We have to contend with reality on its own terms and live in the present and consider the future. No matter how glorious you might think your country was, you cannot go back. Oh, for God's sake. Why is everything on fire? Why is everything on fire? Why is everything always on fire? Yeah. Oh, for crying out loud. Stop. Just stop. All right. There we go. You. Don't. I don't want to die. I don't want to burn to death, but it could happen. Yeah. You can't live in the past, no matter how much you may want to. All right. Put the fire out for now. There we go, that solves that problem. Right. I can appreciate, you might think that the country was great in the 19th century, but leave that shit in the 19th century. Come on. We're living in a world, crying out loud. We're living in a world that is increasingly globalised. Okay? I think the death of the nation state is inevitable. And I know that scares some people. For crying out loud, I've done it again. And you know, change is often scary. These people think, well, these people are different to me. What could we possibly have in common? Well, for one thing, you're all frigging human, right? You know, people think the differences between a British person and a French person, yeah, they're irreconcilable. You know, we'll never have anything in common. There's no reason why we should be so closely linked. And I disagree, right? Like, fundamentally, deep down, we're all the same. We all want the same things. You know, we want to be safe. You want to live safely. You want to live. You want certain amounts of freedom. And I mean, inside, there'll be variations on a theme in regards to that. When I say people want freedom, I don't mean they all want the same kind of freedom. Some people want freedom from various things. People want freedom to do various things. But there's certain fundamental things in humanity. People want to be largely left to their own devices. They want to live life their own way. And, you know, I'm fine with that. And, like I said, I think a lot of the issue people have with the EU is they see it as interfering. You know, to a fair degree it does. But why are laws made in, say, Brussels? It's actually in Brussels, it's in Strasbourg or something like that. I don't know, which one's the commission based? See, I don't even know where the commission is based, but the point I'm getting at is, what does it matter if your laws are made elsewhere? As long as you get a say in how they're made. I mean, that's the issue. I don't care whether my democracy is based in London, in Brussels, or in the corner shop just down the street. As long as it's serving the best interests of the people. And I think in many regards, the EU has often served the best interests of the British people far more than the British government have. Like on rights and stuff, for example, on the environment. I mean, I keep hearing how, you know, we're getting, like, fishermen are complaining because the EU interferes with the quotas they want. And, like, these people literally fish the oceans to death so there were no more fish because they want, oh, the EU is restricting us and that's affecting my income and I can't make as much money. I'm thinking, well, you wouldn't make any money at all if there were no fish left. I mean, come on, let's be realistic. If there are no fish left to fish, you're going to make no money because you're not going to catch anything that isn't there. I mean, I don't know if it's just me that can see the idiocy of the argument, oh, the EU interferes with our fishing quotas and shit. Well, those fishing quotas, I mean, I know a lot of fish gets thrown back because, you know, it gets thrown back dead. But, you know, fishing quotas have done a lot to replenish North Sea stocks, right? So a lot of the species that we eat on a regular basis were very, very much more in danger than they are today because of overfishing in the North Sea. And a lot of what saved that has been UK implementation of EU law. Right? And if you can't see how that's benefited you as a fisherman, well, frankly, I don't think you can be trusted with a vote. And that's my problem, you see. I wouldn't make the vote age required. You know, I won't make it age specific. I wouldn't have, like, if you're over 18, you're a bit, you know, you get to vote. I would have it based on your ability to demonstrate understanding of things. Trouble is, how do you do that in a fair and just way, and how the hell do you implement and monitor it? I mean, you can't. It's impractical. It's thoroughly impractical. So my idea of the ideal system could never possibly happen. Simple as that. And some people would regard it as tyranny, because they would turn around and they would say, well, who decides who is able to do what? You know, who decides what the standard is? I'm like, well, that's the problem. That is the problem. I see no solution to that. You know, it's. So you just have to make do with what you've got, basically. And as unfortunate as that may be, it's just the reality I'm faced with, you know. I'm faced with loathing democracy as it's implemented, being able to do nothing about it. Well, that's life. Okay, I don't know why I just did that. Well, I do, because I wanted to do something different there. But, well, yeah. Okay, y'all. One, two, one top, one on top, one on top. Don't want it to go one, two. I think I do. Yeah, and then just, right, okay. I know what I want to do. Okay. This is going to look really quirky, I think, but it might be better than what we had. That one there, and that. And then one more. Yep. Okay. And that, and I think that might be the way to do it. Oh crap! Keep ballsing it up. Where's it on there? It's right. Boosh! Ow! Ankles. Okay. So I need to get rid of all of this, and I need to make it mirror it. We're almost at 30 minutes as well, which is unfortunate. Oh, am I gonna run out of axe? No, I've got one more. Okay, that should be sufficient to get this done. Let's go down. It's easier to do it from this angle, isn't it? I've got to put the fire out because I would have probably fallen in there and died by now. But yeah, politics. Politics features, I mean, quite heavily, in my opinions, as of late, because it's just such a pressing issue that is of immediate importance. Because as I say, this is going to affect my life. The outcome of this vote affects my life pretty much from now until the end. If we vote to stay, I can't see there being another referendum, and I'll be happy. I believe the EU is broken, but not irreparably so. I think we're going to get better ways of, you know, we're more likely to fix it if we're in it rather than competing against it. And if we leave, oh God, the economic damage to the UK is just going to be, it's going to set us back decades. I mean, no one knows for sure what is going to happen, but you cut, you know, you suddenly create a tariff barrier between you and the, people you do 45% of your trade with, you're gonna create issues that are not necessarily good for you. Simple as that. Anyone who claims they know exactly what's gonna happen is a moron and lying to you and trying to curry favour by pretending they know what they talk about. But we do have a pretty good idea what will go down because we know the scale of our trade with the EU. We know how much it affects the economy. We know how much we pay in as well. These people saying we're losing like what, 350 million a week. It's like, what? Isn't the sim I mean, even if it did cost that much, and okay, if you say it costs 30 million a day, 30 million, 50 million a day, they're saying our membership costs. Yeah, but if you look at the trade that the UK does with the EU, then factor that into it across the 4 year. We get 80 million a day back just in GDP. Well, sorry, GDP trade. Which is GDP, I think. You know, so that statistic there, you know, you're putting in 50 million, you're getting a return of, on top of it, an additional 30 million. To me, that's good business. Neoliberals claim to love economics. Well, get that through your skull. 80 million is bigger than 50 million. And, you know, those are just numbers I've vaguely looked up. And then, you know, it's just, I cannot fathom some people's mentality. Just cannot. Just cannot. And the whole immigration thing, that baffles me as well, because I do not understand how you can be so scared of immigration. just don't understand what about it terrifies people. The UK is in no danger of being overwhelmed by immigrants. It just simply will not happen. You know, there are equal number of births in the UK as there are people who come here to live from abroad. People say, oh yeah, but it's not natives. Well, I'm sorry, if you're born here, you're a native. That's how it works. Okay? I don't give a shit where your family's originally from. No one is, you know, you go back far enough, no one is native to the UK. And these people just do not think. They do not think. It's like they're incapable of rationality. I don't know what it is. I don't understand what terrifies them. What is so bad about these people coming here to live and work? Why? Why would that scare you? I just cannot wrap my head around the mentality. I just cannot. That one's there, isn't it? Right. I don't know. There's possibly some deficiency on my part. Possibly. But I'm not willing to contend that it's necessary. I think there will come a point when the UK will have too many people. I think we probably have got too many people in this country. In some regards, I mean, it has a huge environmental impact, right? The amount of water we take from rivers, for example. I think I've discussed this before. But if you want to address it, you don't address all the little issues, you address the big picture. And the problem is, if there are too many people in the UK, you address all the causes of population increase, not just people moving here, right? If that was your genuine concern, if that is really what keeps you up at night, implement birth quotas. I mean, no one ever will because it violates human rights. You know, this isn't China. For all the UK's failings, it's a democratic society. Right? It's not the perfect democracy because the perfect democracy does not exist. But it's far from the worst, you know? And there is never anything that cannot be improved. It's not like, oh, this is it, we're stuck with it, things as they are. That is never true. Nothing is beyond being changed. Nothing is unfixable. And I believe that is a belief that I hold to quite firmly, frankly. Nothing in terms of, you know, I don't mean literally nothing. I mean in terms of this country, its institutions, the EU, any international organization or anything like that, it is all fixable. That needs to be something else. So I really do not understand why some people get their knickers in a twist over it. I really don't. I mean, it bugs me because, like I keep saying, this is going to affect me for life. That isn't right. That is not right at all. Oh, these should be. Yeah, I've done that wrong. But yeah, you know what I'm getting at. I hate that people are going to be able to make decisions that seriously affect me. And they're not even going to do it with a thinking mind, all right? They're going to do it with their pre-existing political bias and their emotions. And you got to live life with your heart. Well, that's fine until someone has to actually pay the bills and someone has to think with their head, all right? We don't all have the luxury of thinking with our hearts. It'd be a nice world if the best thing you could always do was think with your heart, don't you think? Well, yeah. Anyway, I really am going to stop ranting now, guys, because we've come to the end of the episode. So if you've managed to put up with all of that, thank you. You know, it's just something that keeps bugging me. It really is. But for now, well, ow, there go my ankles. We're going to have to call it a day, guys. It's a day. So I've really overran whilst I've been ranting. The roof's looking a bit better. We will finish it. We will finish it. I'm determined. But you know, till next time. This is Friday's episode, isn't it? Yeah, I'll see you for more Minecraft on Monday tomorrow. City Skylines, I think. That should be fun. But for now, Live long and pester.
Yeah.
Ta-ra! If you enjoy my efforts to be vaguely entertaining, you can now support me on Patreon. A dollar, a pound, a yen, a euro, whatever you've got, whatever you can spare, all helps. Over 1 million fed. Thank you for watching, and ta-ra!